We are right now starting the Food and Friends tour. Starting it off right with food.
And friends.
Got this Troy boy. And this Luke man.
That's good.
I didn't mean to call you a boy and him a man, but it just came out that way.
I'm a he-man.
It's not my fault your name rhymes with boy. So we have a show in Lansing tonight and I'm going to pick up an Andrew.
This is the house.
Sandy, ready to fit?
Post number one.
Post
of Twa. Posts.
I got so scared.
That red house though.
You gonna be hitting the kendama on that thing?
Are you getting a job?
Oh, look at those skills.
Are you just four elbows?
This song is called You Got It. So sing it if you know it, hum it if you don't. There are some parts where I want you to join me, and you should hear a few other people joining in during that part. But it goes, vocally, not medically. Okay, so here we go. To get rich, buy bigger things, surrender your dreams, die with the people you chose to believe. They got the suits, they're five-year plans. I bet that you don't think that I'm a man. Cause I play guitar, teach high school kids. Sure you don't end up like me did.
You like how I tried to blame you right there?
I'll sing a song.
Yeah, thanks.
You'll sing along. And slip past the fact that you got it wrong. And I hope that
running around.
You never wanted me gone, but your actions spoke different. Your actions spoke different. You never wanted me gone. You never wanted me gone, but your actions spoke different. Your actions spoke different. For you never wanted me gone. You never wanted me gone, but your actions spoke different. Your actions spoke different. You never wanted me gone. You never wanted me gone, but your actions spoke different. Your actions spoke no room for words.
Thanks a lot.
Yeah.
So I'm Elise. I've never done this before. No one's ever heard my poem.
Woo!
Yeah! Yeah! I'm just gonna see how this goes. I have to read them off my phone because one of them I just wrote yesterday, so I don't know it too well. But thanks to Chris and Jess, because you guys inspired me to actually start writing my poetry, and now I'm doing this. So, yeah. Okay, so this first one, I wrote this last year, and it's just kind of this dialogue going through my head as I was trying to figure out, like, why am I in college, what am I doing with my life, and just, like, who I want to become. So, here it is. Alone, I sit in my room, me, myself, and I, all fighting in my head. They never seem to agree on what I should do. Should I find someone real to talk to? No, it's too much effort. They don't even care. Should I be productive? It's not worth it anyways. Who cares about grades? I guess the only option is to get lost in thought again. Well, here we go. Thinking of all the choices that I've made, I wonder what I've become. Who am I? A monster? A saint? Or nothing? Does my future follow the American dream and everything else that our society screams? To be smart, successful, to make lots of money, to be one step ahead of everyone else and make them bow down. To be young and wild, only living for the night, or am I doing what my parents want me to do in order to live out their dreams? To graduate from med school with honors and to make more money than they ever did, to pay for lavish gifts in their retirement, to be their trophy firstborn daughter, nothing more than a list of accomplishments to tell all their wine-drinking friends. I slowly reach out and try to grasp my dreams to make them a part of me, only to find them just out of reach. But the world says, don't give up. You'll reach your dreams soon. All you have to do is try, and you'll find your way. But your dream? Well, it's stupid. Wow, that's so inspirational. I wish I could do something like that, but I really want to make money. Amidst all the noise, I just want to be me. But me is nothing more than a fragile piece of glass, allowing people to see right through me as if I don't exist, or trying to reflect what they see, so maybe they'll like me. But I want to be stained glass, with a deep, rich color, a piece that individually looks pretty, but is gorgeous in the whole picture. I want to shine clear and bright, letting the sun light me up. I want to be the piece I was made to be. Thank you.
Food and Friends Day 2. What are we rocking?
Hawaiian pizza roll.
All of our footage is just going to be food and friends. Friends with food.
Seems
in hand.
Appropriate.
So we're just kind of hanging with the food. About to make a mess load of pancakes. And this is where the quasi magic happens. Right there. We have birthdays.
Yay,
and we have cupcakes.
Yay, cupcakes.
Star Wars cupcakes.
And pancakes.
Wooden Pikachus. In his, heavyweight face. His other face.
And then another one after that.
Look at the phases.
Andrew Warner, Taylor, Michigan. Here we go. Oh, we gotta get it started first.
No, I don't think
we gotta get it started first.
We gotta have Destiny in the background.
Here we go.
I can't.
Alright, signing off. It's a miss for Taylor, Michigan. Yeah.
The cupcake. What's your thoughts?
It's a theme. Today is a theme party.
Your thoughts on the taste of a cupcake is it's a theme.
It's a theme. It's a theme taste. It tastes like Star Wars.
Be your worst critic. How are they?
They're okay.
They're okay? Is she lying?
I'm gonna answer your question with the statement that I've already prepared.
It tastes like Star Wars.
I said it tastes like war and bitter parents.
Pancake game about to go down? Troy? Mr. Chris?
Hey, what's up?
Ready for this action?
Prayerfully.
Sleep-a-bonds? How you doing?
What up, though?
Don't mean to put you on the spot, but I mean to put you on the spot.
Have you seen my car keys?
Yeah, I have them in my pocket. I'm taking yours. Oh, don't. No. So we got those pancakes going. Got that bacon going. I'm behind the camera, so I'm going to have to film as I do it. Oh, look at that boy.
Yeah.
Looking all tasty.
Endorsed.
Endorsed by a coffee drink. We have to clarify that it's a coffee drink.
I'm assuming video because he's moving around.
It's the club. Oh, it's glorious. We need to put this more on the big screen, sir.
Oh, you can. It's possible.
Huh? All right, so before Andrew gets started, I have one poem I wanted to share with you guys. This is one that I've only performed one time, so I don't have it memorized or anything. I wrote it quite a few years back. Chris, when did you write Plan B?
Chris. Spring of 2009.
Okay, so this was written just before that. Chris has a very, I'd say a blatant ripoff of this one. So this is like the original one. It's called Strategy 2. A man named Josh Mozart once said, "The world seems chilly to you. It could be because you live in Michigan." But Josh, that's dandy and all. But it's time to be a little more aggressive. Downriver, it's at its go. Now it's time to move to Orlando. I'll spread warmth like a word so big I don't know the meaning of it. Poison the elderly with it. Transport it through an EpiPen, a panda, or even worse. I'll surf the sea waves in it. Bring it to your workplace and your retirement home while I eat your Oreos. Kick back and watch your TV. Ignite a fire as I corrupt your children. You thought global warming was bad? Mm-mm. I'll sneak it into your water supply. Release it into the biodome.
Polysorbate
and its toxins flood the atmosphere. I'll coat every beagle and rubber chicken with it. I'll put in every pill and in place of the cold on your freezer's chill. I'll sleep it into the blood banks wired in every scone. I'll radiate your food with it. Bad as 8 Mile the movie on various drugs with no place to take out all that pent up roid rage! Except on you and your familia. I'll make it the common anti-cold, birthed in air, sea, land, and even thought. Incubation time will be minimal. I won't say zero, but that's kind of unrealistic. Quarantines are silly. I mean, there's really no point in sheltering yourself from the heat. I'll AOL instant message it, subliminally and otherwise, pump it into the mail, pump it in every variety of sub at Subway. Stick it in change returns and ATMs. I'll hide in your closet and under your bed. I'll drop space heaters from a plane or send it far and wide in Canada. Small guy, tubby dude, warm your hearts up. Put down the mobile device. Don't bother calling anyone. Not the commies, the fascists, your mother, but maybe my mother. Tell her you love her, but like a friend, don't make a move on my mom, bro. We will not be stopped. All opposition will fail. Hollywood, we won't have a winter-themed blockbuster other than Frozen that could hold a candle to the fire I'm about to unleash. No one will escape unwarmed. There will only be warm bodies.
First poem is called War of a Man. All right, so here we go. In this darkest hour, in this familiar state of limbo, where the darkest of dreams become a simple reality for my forever tortured soul. Why am I so quick to fall into the clutches of falsehood? Because I am a man of men whose heart was weak, whose heart chose not to beat for love but selfish deeds. Forgive me and my bleeding mind as I follow my shadows and demons so I can watch them die. So I thought. And so here I am again, with a broken testimony in my dreams, where I choose not to succeed, but instead I choose to evade the guilt, shame, and brokenness that came along with my choices. I am not who I should be. That's the first one. I don't wanna waste my life wishing that I could be somewhere else. Wishing that I could be someone else. I'm stuck with what I've got.
Woo! Watch out for the PS4!
And I don't wanna waste my life wishing that I could be somewhere else. Wishing that I could be someone else. I'm not who I'm not.
Circle pit.
First chance I get, I'm getting myself out of here. Running to the core and out the core. What's the best that movie ever? Wishing that I could be someone else. I'm stuck with what I've got. I don't want to waste my life wishing that I could be somewhere else. I'm wishing that I could be someone else. I'm not who I'm not. Be the one to see the California sun. I wanna be the one who looks deeply into your eyes. I wanna be the one to see the California sunrise. Wishing that I could be someone else. I'm not who I've got. I don't want to waste my life wishing that I could be somewhere else. Wishing that I could be someone else. I'm not who I'm not. And I don't want to waste my life wishing that I could be somewhere else. Wishing that I could be someone else. I'm not who I'm not. And I don't want to waste my life wishing that I could be somewhere else. Wishing that I could be someone else. I'm not who I'm not.
Luke, are you going for a run?
Yeah. Just be careful out there, alright?
It's a dangerous area. I knew a guy?
This ain't Grand Rapids anymore.
That's all I have to say. I knew a guy. I don't know him anymore because he went for a run.
Running in Taylor. Mm-hmm. I'm about to shower in Taylor.
That's dangerous too, equally.
More food and more friends. And Logan doesn't want to be on camera apparently.
How was that food game?
I don't.
It's food.
You got some eggs?
And I'm having it with friends.
Oh, are you?
Well, you ran off, but I thought we were.
Yeah. I see you in three empty chairs.
You don't know where I've been. I don't know who I am.
Apparently not. Thought it did. Alright, so we got five guys worth of stuff.
That's a burger place. Five Guys should have sponsored this. What are we doing?
I thought they did. Dude, that
I'm off the tour.
That's the only way. That was the only reason I was coming.
You mean I've been stealing their food the past few days?
So yeah, we have all our merch and all of our stuff trying to cram in this boy.
Brown bagging it today.
A brown bagging every day. DIY for life.
The proverbial brown bag. It's actually a cooler.
Yeah, Andrew didn't learn his colors as a child.
Rubbermaid Brian.
Andrew, I hate to break it to you, but that's red.
I've been living a lie.
Or wait, actually, I think that's gold and black.
Well, this dress, to me, looks white and gold.
Yeah.
Food and friends, we got plenty of ramen.
Their bumper
stickers. If all else fails, we got plenty of ramen.
Awesome.
Yeah. There's our home for the next 9-ish days.
So today I thought I was gonna eat some refrigerated eggs. Turned out that they were sitting out all night, so I put them in my mouth and I swallowed. And about 20 minutes later, they shot right through my intestines. And I gotta go really bad. Gosh! So I'm about to I'm literally about to poop my pants. So,
we're just trying to find a field or something.
There's a house.
Yeah, it's a little outhouse.
We're kind of like just on the back roads.
I can't feel anything in my body right now except for my colon.
Oh my gosh. Go. Turn.
Pass them up right on the right. I think I pooped. So
in your pants?
Yeah, I think a little bit. I farted and a little bit came on my butt.
Oh, no. Wonderful.
There's a little forest over there.
Do you want to make that? Can you make that run?
I wouldn't.
No. Just drive over the.
Yeah, let's just drive over the forest.
I'm not driving over a field. Does this sound good?
Yeah, I'll buy anything.
I'll buy anything.
Just give me everything, man.
This is the one.
Except for eggs. Oh. Oh.
Go, Warner, go.
Go.
Poor guy.
I'll buy anything, everything, just not eggs.
Just no eggs.
Dude.
I bought a 6-pack of Pepsis for us.
Thank you.
I literally don't remember what I said. I'll take anything but eggs. I'll take anything but eggs. Where's your bathroom? And so I just ran into the bathroom. She's like, I got a whole van full of boys out there, and I don't know what to get them. So I came back out. She's like, I don't know what you want, sweetheart. You want some pops?
Wait,
how many people are in your van?
Did she say that?
Yeah, she was so nice.
You think I can go too? Not. I just need to pee.
You should run in there. No. Say the exact same thing.
Anything
just go in there and say, I'll sell you this pretzel and use your bathroom.
That was just a
I doubt that that was the eggs. What did we eat yesterday? My sub. You think the sub did it?
What else? You should refrigerate your food.
Yeah. That was the biggest problem. I know what happened. I took the whole bag out when we were eating the monster sub, the PB&J sub.
And then you left it out.
And then I left it out. And then I shoved it in my stupid face. I shoved it in my stupid face and I pooped everywhere all over Ohio.
I mean that
doesn't matter, dude. Ohio's a toilet anyway.
You probably
except for that place. They were great. If you ever go there, they're great. I'm not gonna tell you where, but if you go there, they're great.
We could do a roof show.
That'd be sick.
Dude, that would be sick. Okay.
You wanna go up on the roof?
Tight pants.
Right. Tight pants. I'm not getting out.
You're not getting out?
I'm feeling like it.
Yeah, it's kinda steep. I don't feel good about going out with the camera.
Dude, with that backdrop though.
Wow. Luke, are we doing roof show?
Dude, there's plenty of space. I'm like not insanely afraid of heights, but I'm pretty afraid of heights right now.
Yeah.
Luke, you can do it.
Well, I guess you're kind of high up, considering there's a valley down here.
Here, you can just climb up. We can
keep myself. Chris was considering jumping from there.
But God's good.
To there.
Appropriate decision.
Yeah, he's not going to because he wants to live.
You should come up here.
He's in love with being alive.
I'm in love with being alive.
We're looking for a kendama business.
Right on Lynn.
Yeah, that's supposedly in the middle of a neighborhood.
Are you shooting this?
Yeah, sure. All
right. Do I always ask that whenever you actually are?
Yeah.
Okay, I should just turn around when you're, yeah, instead of asking.
Luke?
Yeah.
Fill us in.
What happened in the last episode.
So, we got this address. I don't know, they found it online where they sell kendamas.
In theory,
Yeah, I guess. And it said go in the breezeway, so we went in the breezeway. And then they all started freaking out and trying to leave, and I wouldn't let them. And yeah, this lady.
How old is she?
Probably she didn't really know what was going on. I think she thought we were trying to buy drugs, and she was really confused.
Yeah, so all that to say, we found the kendamas. The old lady sells them.
Just kidding.
Kendama is not real.
Found out the kendama scene in PA is dead. Or very close to it.
Oh.
We just terrified an old lady. Walked in her house.
What if she's like...
Interrupted her dog. Asked for what she doesn't even know. Yeah. That could have gone a lot better.
Yeah, we could have had the camera in there. Yeah. Well, I didn't want to. I don't know. It was
she
weird.
She definitely called the cops.
We're making the... We're cooking. We're pretty good cookers.
What are we cooking, though?
Shout out.
Massive amounts of ramen. Nature's nectar.
Nature's nectar, that is what they call it.
Yeah, it is what, I mean, that's what they call it, like, meaning us right now.
Who says that?
I don't know.
Us?
Everyone.
Sweet. How much are we doing here? Like, enough for everybody?
All that ramen in that boy.
Just cramming it now. This is gonna be a mess. A mess of good. Yes. Look at it. All of its glory. Like chips.
Vagabonds.
Is the water to the brim?
Is that a bad idea?
I think it's the best idea I've seen.
I know a lot about cooking.
Hey, the beaver's do your thing.
J-stick right here.
Watch it.
Oh!
Alright, signing off to Williamsport.
Better luck tomorrow.
Yeah, there's a lot of water.
That's there. Ridiculous.
Okay.
Dude,
I know what I work in a movie theater. I know what I'm doing.
They serve ramen.
I cook a lot. The closest thing to this is
hot. It serves ramen at a movie theater.
Hey, don't judge us, man. You don't know what it takes to live this life.
This is a Food and Friends tour. We're pros at this.
It's a Food and Friends tour.
Yeah, sell me on Pennsylvania. Like, I've been learning a lot.
Oh, we have emus and lions and apparently bears everywhere. Oh, so it's fun.
What city do you live in?
Raccoon.
Raccoon. What animal do you have?
A raccoon.
What did your mom used to do?
A lion tamer.
Like what else can you give me about Pennsylvania?
Sheets.
This is totally
sheets. Yeah, sheets.
Chris
is a
can give me that one.
We don't have sheets. That I mean, lions and emus aside, sheets takes the cake.
We have Canadian geese.
Yeah, we do have Canadian geese.
Oh, cool. Every state has one. It's in a migratory pattern.
But my dad's been kicked out of Canada for illegal horse trading.
Oh yeah,
illegal.
I keep opening.
Most interesting.
I'm still recording. I just can't.
I mean,
I just can't handle this.
I just can't even.
That, okay, so you can't just say that story.
It's a thing.
It's a thing. Yeah, like this is a common occurrence with Pennsylvanian residents. They get kicked out of Canada
for illegal horse training. It happens more often than you think.
Apparently, I didn't know it happened at all. Oh, season that boy.
Oh no.
That's so outrageous.
Oh my God.
Luke, I feel really good about this ramen.
Yeah. Me too.
That thing's a beast. MSG? That's enough MSG to kill a man. Or to change a light bulb. Doing is just drawing names out of hats.
Hey,
so what's order for dinner?
What? I'm really sorry.
Andrew, your head
kept on hold five.
It's that heart attack at the top.
Because the savers.
Vagabonds three. French sword four.
Make my blood.
Some dude two.
I'm not from here.
I like how I did this in sequence.
We're doing ramen shots.
Straight edge life. We got one more.
Who wants a shot of ramen?
It's just Charlie, get the shot of ramen.
It's just ramen.
It's just ramen. It's not spiked ramen or anything. I don't know how you can spike ramen, but...
One, broth is two, ramen three. Oh, that was cool.
Didn't you?
You didn't even get the full shot. Come on.
Alright.
Oh, chew it for vagabonds.
Luke's like, nope.
Totally documenting right, this, I'm sorry.
Did you just blow on that?
on, Luke. You can
should
do
we
that.
Get enough?
I'll take it.
Hey, there's ramen in the kitchen for everybody.
Everybody.
So, yeah, there's ramen for everybody.
Help yourself.
It's the favorite restaurant.
Man looks like he's got sick food with facial hair.
A lot.
Talked doesn't mean that we talked, doesn't tell you that I'm fine. Surface level afterthought, I'm not been okay with the fact that you're okay with the fact that we've been growing apart quite a lot. I'm gonna try my best to forget we were at the Lord. The cheap talk and cheaper reasoning, it's not what I had planned. I'm not what you had in mind. Doesn't mean that we try. So why do both of us feel alright? This kept me up at night a lot. Did you not think about all the times we talked about all the times you said we'd gotta be worth this shot? I'm gonna try my best to forget we were ever more than cheap talk. Cheaper reasoning, it's not what I had planned. I'm not what you had in mind. Until regret we were at the more. The cheap talking, cheaper reasoning, it's not what I had planned. I'm not what you had in mind. What you had in mind. It's to know that the sun is you. You feel so far away, and it hurts to know that the sun is you. You feel so far away, far away. We're gonna try my best to forget we were ever more. Cheap talking, cheaper reasoning, it's not what I had planned. I'm not what you had in mind. To regret we were ever more than cheap talking, cheaper reasoning, it's not what I had planned. I'm not what you had in mind. What you had in mind.
The song we heard like 2 days ago. This is like our test run for things. Yeah, that one. Good. You can take it off.
Yeah.
Something.
Wait, this is where I make a conscious change in direction, so yeah. I don't make the same mistakes. Please stay, cause I can shoulder all the weight, the implications of every action that I take. My chains, and I'll just lie here and wither away. And hey, babe, is this
what you meant when you said fate always gets the final say. 'Cause I don't feel alright, the candlelight, thinking more about the bridge and not the other side. I can smell the kerosene in the air tonight. This place is gonna burn, gonna light the fire.
Waking up.
Hey, Cameron. Get that crap out of my face.
But there's food. But there's food.
How are you doing?
Got some hash browns, I guess. Some potatoes, yeah. Not fully awake, so I'll probably identify things as what they're not actually. Chicken. In egg form. Wheat as biscuits.
Oh my gosh, you guys rock.
It's a pig.
For the Let's just have another show here tonight.
Listen to it sizzle.
The eggs are sizzling.
Listen to the bacon sizzle. As the eggs do their thing.
I have been holding my breath for
too many nights in a row. And somewhere on coastlines unknown to me, you paint your dreams with reds and blues and greens.
Get in there.
Somewhere.
You have the base, man.
Get in there.
And there's salt.
You sold me, dude. That's so neat.
Yes, potatoes.
Watch out.
Watch out and then eat them.
That's what we do. Watch out, watch out, then eat them.
Something bacon about to be in my stomach.
The vat. If you leave ramen overnight,
it turns into gravy. Amazing.
Science, science.
You are alchemists.
Science.
Amazing.
Science in the car, boys.
Hi, guys.
Hi.
Hi.
How are you?
They're just doing kendama on the hill.
We're doing the V-stick. You got it?
Yep. You ready?
Yep. Wait, that didn't count. Hold on.
He tries this one trick every stop. He's just gonna keep doing it until he gets it.
It's because I'm on a hill. That's the only reason. I'm not nailing this right now.
I believe in you.
Yeah, here. We're just gonna cut right to the chase. Here we go. Williams Fort. Oh, all right. Signing out. I haven't made it yet.
Where's Luke? I just saw him run up the hill.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What?
He just ran up the hill and disappeared.
Disappeared.
Mm-hmm. He could be anywhere. If you see him in this video clip, there he is. It's like a Where's Waldo. We got Easter cookies for the show.
Box out the burn store.
Dude, friends.
Go eat them an hour later.
You can have one now.
Gosh. Thank you, Kendra.
Mm-hmm.
Luke is somewhere out there.
Thank you for making it.
Crying. This is stuck in a trap.
Got robbed.
More food. It's almost like this is the theme of the tour.
Same amount of friends.
I love themes.
It's all we do.
Except Luca Bonds got eaten by a dog or a bear.
A dog? I didn't know there were wild dogs.
Shout out to the last trip. We got eaten by a coyote.
Mm-hmm. Luca Bonds is dead.
But we have lasagna, so that's cool.
This is the new Luke. We're going to bring this on tour with us. Put it in front of him.
We already started eating. Luke's still up there wandering.
All those who wander aren't lost.
Except for Luke.
Except for Luke. Justin.
But all those who wander.
He's enjoying that outdoor.
Welcome to the Food and Friends and Luke tour.
The food and Friends and We Lost Our Son tour.
Looking for the show entrance. We're here at Lycoming College for some hardcore parkour, you know, stuff and things. This is the site for tonight, I think. The performance hall.
Yeah, this is your college, this building?
I'm gonna say it one more time before I start to shut up. You guys have no idea how special this is, man. I love this place with all my heart. Yeah, man, 4 years of my life, poetry started here. My faith bloomed in like a really real way.
Retired.
Missed them all.
Really?
Yes.
Don't miss this. Oh!
Tell me what to do.
This one is about just, I guess it's kind of that conflict of wanting to pursue God, but I don't know, just kind of getting distracted by life. And it's called I'm Hungry. So if you guys want to say the first few lines with me, it's feed me, Lord, for I, your little sheep, am hungry.
Feed me, Lord, for I, your little sheep, am hungry.
I ain't talking some piddly appetizer. A little taste to make me feel better and satisfy my palate.
Come on.
Mm-hmm. I've been taking small bites long enough of quote unquote just enough to realize that you are more than enough, and I need so much more of you. I'm talking like a big old grace buffet. so overwhelming that it trims my guilt and shame away. Though some may taste a tad tart, I know it's because the good stuff tastes bitter than my cold heart. Because I've tasted and I've seen, but I still have a tendency to develop an appetite for all the things I neglectfully place between you and me. Transform these little taste buds on my tongue to crave you like when my faith was young and new. I want to taste and see so heavily, but I'll know with total clarity it's only you who satisfies. Munching on that cheap imitation love leaves me empty and striving for more. It's nothing like the soul-piercing food coma I get from being with you. Not nearly as much indigestion. My stomach ain't churning, but my heart is yearning for that delectable soul food I can't get anywhere else. Fill my dehydrated gullet with streams of your living water that'll never run dry. Fill me up with you till I'm so full that those around me can't deny that the living God of all is alive inside. Thanks,
yes, sir.
Are you recording?
Yep.
Hey, Ivy.
I'm so glad.
Here's Ivy. Chris is about to perform a poem in the bathroom.
I'm going to accidentally step on the handle and flush.
This little lid of mine.
1, 2, 3. Lucy, that's nice and all, but it's time to get a little more aggressive.
You see, kindling, it's had its go, and now it's time for an inferno. I'll spread love like a pestilence.
Boys in the wild with an epidemic of pandemic.
Hello.
Hey, how are you?
Good.
We're shooting a video in the back.
We're doing a poem.
What? We're shooting a video, making a video.
Video.
Poem.
It's a poem.
Okay. How long are you all going to be here?
We'll be out about 30 minutes or so.
Yeah. We're locking up.
Okay, yeah, cool. Thank you.
Appreciate it.
This little.
I
remember,
like how
you
just accepted it.
You did? I was going to tell him. You were like, no.
Oh, shoot, I thought you were just checking.
No, that's why I was going downstairs.
I don't think I showed where we were yet.
I thought you were like telling him.
Okay, poison the well with it.
Poison the well is going to make it an epidemic, a pandemic, or even worse. I'll conquer the airways with it, bring it to your workplace and your home, play it through your stereo, your TV, your MP3, play the piper as I corrupt your children with it. You thought MTV was bad, I'll sneak it into your water supply, release it into the ozone, and let its toxins. I'll cut every needle and rubber glove with it, put in every pill and place the lead on your windowsill, slip it into the blood banks, wired into the phone. I'll even radiate your food with the baddest 3-mile inch, Chernobyl and HGH and anabolics, and with no place to take out all that
pent up rage!
Except on you and your
family.
I'll make the common cold airborne, seaborne, landborne,
thoughtborne.
Incubation time will be zero. Quarantines will only make it worse. I'll message it.
Subliminally and otherwise.
Put it in the mail, bump it to the subway, stick it to change returns at ATMs, so hide in your closet, under your bed, drop it from a plane, you're set it for a ride
on the missile.
Little boy,
fat man, eat your hearts out.
Now put down the phone, don't bother calling anyone, not the army, the navy, your lawyer, or your mother, because this
cannot be stopped.
All opposition will fail. Hollywood, they won't have a summer blockbuster starring the resistance, because no one,
absolutely no one,
will escape untouched. By the grace of God, there will only be survivors. Thanks, guys. That's really cool.
Woo!
Hey,
first bathroom set.
Bathroom.
Bathroom sessions.
How are the pancakes, friend?
Delicious. They're really good. They're so big. Look at those.
They take up most of the plate. How's the pancake making?
It's going great.
More batter left. We've had so much breakfast food on this tour. I love it. Look at their glory.
Thank you.
Yeah, get some good cologne. Get some
Pennsylvania's Statue of Liberty.
Alright, cool. Hey, this is day 5. This is the Catonsville J-Stick. Here we go.
You get it?
Yes! Day 5! Woo!
And time is never wasted, only spent well or somewhere else. And I can't help but feeling elsewhere since you showed me you were someone else. It's not right, you promised me forever, an account you can't deliver. So you wrote it off as just a season. Was it your plan to act till you believed it? Did you really think it wouldn't hurt so bad when you sold yourself on leaving? And I know I tried to make it work, and that's the trouble with trying too hard to start a fire, cause sometimes we get burned. Somewhere else, and when it comes to being elsewhere, you can only protect yourself. It's not fair, you wish that things were different. You made it clear it's not the distance that kept your heart away from mine. Was it your plan? Did you really think it wouldn't hurt so bad when you sold yourself on leaving? And I know I tried to make it work, and that's the trouble of trying too hard to start a fire, is sometimes I get burned. I force myself out of being nervous. I told myself I'm being nervous. To act till you believed it. And did you really think it wouldn't hurt so bad when you sold yourself on leaving? And I know I tried to make it work, and that's the trouble of trying too hard to start a fire. And sometimes was it your plan? Did you really think it wouldn't hurt so bad when you sold yourself on leaving? And I know I tried to make it work, and that's the trouble of trying too hard to start a fire, is sometimes we get burned.
Thank you.
There's a song, it's called This Little Light of Mine. If you have not heard this song before, it goes, "This Little Light of Mine, I'm Gonna Let It Shine."
literally, it can't get simpler.
So
you sing that three times, at the third time, go let it shine, let it shine, let it shine. We're gonna scream something, and we're gonna pray to Jesus the cops stay away, and that no one thinks we got murdered, like a group murder. Well, guys, I'd love to die with you. One, two, three.
This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. Let it shine, let it shine, let it shine. Jesus! Make me an infinite supernova. I wanna be a light so bright that they can see for hundreds of thousands of millions of billions of trillions of miles so far. Yeah, I've used those big scientific words that I don't know so well. Jesus, make me a light so they can see what you've done and still do for me. Jesus, make me a light so they can see how you saved me, how you changed me, how you saved me from hell in this life and eternity as well. Pause too long. Jesus, make me a light so they can see when I was deep down in pits of sin, so deep and dark, God. I can tell myself from the sin, man. You just stand up there on high, all like...
Chris.
Yeah. Break your nose.
My feet are dirty. I didn't want to get it on the cab. Is that a cab? Yeah, is that what it's called? Oh, okay.
You're a cab.
I'm not. Longest intermission. This is the equivalent of my tuning. Josh Moser, who are we doing today?
Scott Stapp.
Scott Stapp. Yo. Hey. Remember, I was down there. I couldn't tell myself from the sin. It really sucked. And for serious, it did. It was awful. And it's happened a lot, unfortunately, because I'm an idiot. Hey, man. Hey. It looks rough down there. Well, listen. Listen. Me and the Holy Spirit and Scott Stapp and, you know, Jerry Falwell, man. We all... I like Jerry Falwell. He's a really cool guy, so I'm not making fun of him. We all went down...
You didn't say anything about Stapp.
I said Scott Stapp.
No, I mean, you're like, Falwell's cool, but... I clarify about the Falwell, but...
I literally don't know who Scott Stapp is. I think he's the singer of Creed. Yeah, I don't know. I've never heard that band.
You know
Stapp.
You know
Stapp. Stapp
it,
man. Sorry, Scott Stapp. This has just gone horribly awry. Well, listen, hey, man, I didn't just go and get you a Bible track, John 3:16. Yeah, good luck. No, Jesus, none of that. Please, God, none of that. Give me your light so they can see how you came right down in there, wrapped your arms around me and got freaking messy with it, and pulled me right on out of there, made me whole and complete in you. Jesus, I will be whatever size light you need me to be. I'll be the supernova, or a lighthouse, or a big old searchlight, or I promise. You need something smaller, I'll just be a tap light or a pen light, one of those cool little race car keychain flashlights like my parents got me for Christmas. Come on, just please,
Jesus, make me your light. Just please, Jesus, make me your light. Just please, Jesus, make me your light. And let it shine, let me shine, let me shine.
Cool, thanks. We turned a minute and a half poem into like 24.
Good old Mexican casserole, courtesy of Chris's mama. Pick those boys up.
Whoa.
Far heftier than I was expecting.
Carrot cake is metal.
Need more friends.
More friends.
Strawberries.
This is a pregame show.
What do we have there? The reveal.
It's just breakfast casserole.
And there was much rejoicing.
Whoa. Who do you?
And we got some blueberry muffins. Well, not just blueberry.
We got some cranberry orange.
Banana nut. And blueberry. Not messing around.
We're about to serve these tasty burgers to the crowds of people.
Goes, guys. I was going to say, some of those burgers don't look very good.
They're evolving.
Oh, okay. They'll turn into burgers. Yeah.
Hey, we got to do the shot. No, I should have retired. I should retire the shot because I actually hit it.
Oh, yeah. At first,
plays music and you have spoken word.
Spoken word.
You raised your hand.
Music. I do a thing.
If you know it, please sing along.
that I can't write, keep paying the toll. I know that it seems like I'm always upset. I know it seems like I'm always upset. All that I know is your space is empty.
So we have breakfast being made. Got some bacon and some eggs, sausage, pancakes, all good things. I'm Sarah here. Samantha Joe and Sarah there. And Taylor Swift in the background being the soundtrack of our lives.
I don't know what to say because I just heard Gideon, so I was wondering if this was on the same vinyl.
Yeah, it's the Taylor Swift Gideon split.
Dinah.
Statesville.
The upper room.
Check this, son.
Impressive.
Okay, so who's never seen me before? Alright, cool. Everyone's raising their hands a liar. So, if you've never seen me before, it's gonna be really loud. You might feel uncomfortable for just a second, but don't feel uncomfortable. You'll be fine, maybe. 1, 2, 3. So hold your breath and open your ears up wide, cause these words are gasoline and I brought the matches. Nice, you guys are good. Beneath the glow of Marlboro lights, smoke my man and look past one another, counting the ageless bricks like sins or stars or Hail Marys. You'll find me, a corroded burned barrel rusting and cracking into the pavement. Planted like a tombstone beside a strip club and a foreclosed shoe store, catty corner to an exit door someone welded shut and a fire escape that couldn't hold anyone. Look inside me. You'll find used condoms and dirty needles, chopsticks and a fitness magazine, a rag doll and a scale model of the Eiffel Tower, going up alongside a couple of beer bottles bought with somebody else's tithe money in yesterday's newspaper. The leg of a dresser twice painted over sticks halfway out and leans on a family photo album that didn't survive the divorce and half the headboard of a dead son's bed. If the thought of what you might metaphorically be breathing in right now is making you uncomfortable, don't worry. I'm just being honest. I'm a whole lot of things being made new. Some of it might need to take some time, burn all the way down into unidentifiable ash and get tossed in the bay and sink to the bottom. Wait a few decades, get dredged up again and used to fertilize a garden. Grow some cherry tomatoes or some squash or some corn or zucchini out of old TVs on a rooftop overlooking a mural of men hammering their AKs and Glocks in the plows. But trust me, it is all getting redeemed, every single bit of it. And so now I'm just trying to tip myself over, roll down any street God lets me, spew my flaming guts onto anyone I can. Trying to catch a porch or a house or a subdivision, a block or a city or a county or a nation or just a single person on fire. Watch him burn. Pray that he bumps into all of his friends and spreads that fire like a rumor made of STDs and the flu. Pray that he catches the neighbor's house on fire, sits down for dinner and catches the tablecloth and then the whole family on fire. Or that he plunges himself into a convenience store or a crowded congregation or a subway station or into a deserted Pacific island or the FDA or the CDC or Hollywood or Ann Arbor onto every desk. My alma mater into the wheat fields outside of town. Burns down blocks and acres and miles and time zones and continents. So go ahead, pick up a piece of me if you're curious. Let the coal be pushed under your lips. Maybe you can taste the piece of what was given, the spark that was first put inside of me. Let it touch touch your teeth. Let its song sing through your jawbone, climb up into your ear, run your synapses like a ridge line made in the Colorado wildfire. Maybe you can even commiserate with the rocks. Understand a tiny portion of what they have kept up inside. The Hosanna they have been singing since the Creator first left his fingerprints on their edges. Yeah, this is arson. Not for the revenge or the insurance money, but because we need it, and I want it now. Coat myself in napalm and juggle fireworks while skipping through a charcoal factory, fill my sneakers with black powder, and run through all the oil refineries lighting matches like it's my job. Because it is. Wait, it's not done. Sorry. I just like to be honest. I want to hear the volcanoes. I want to hear the volcanoes harmonize with this fire. Watch the Father's breath flow through the blowpipe into us, elongating and shaping and curving us until we are all one enormous obsidian cathedral, vortexing in a celestial crescendo, molten light, taking shape over and over, burning clay in the potter's hands, becoming the final pot, the final body, the bride, more and more. Yeah, I want to see the fire and sing its hymns, bellow its poetry to praise the Father and fan the flames. And this room is a stabilized all oxygen environment, then I want to smoke all of my cigarettes at once. That this world's Tinder, not the dating app, but the stuff you start fires with. There is confusion. If this world's Tinder, California with no rain for months, then I want to be the flower girl at the wedding, tossing gasoline for rose petals and the ring bearer too, handing a single match to the groom, and he's got a thing for flames. Yeah, this is arson, because I've got this fire shut up inside of my bones, and I am weary of keeping it. If I have my way, I hope you burn.
Nice. Warner Bonds.
If I don't wanna waste my life wishing that I could be somewhere else, wishing that I could be someone else, I'm stuck with what I've got. I don't wanna waste my life wishing that I could be somewhere else, wishing that I could be someone else. I'm stuck with what I've got. Don't you remember the last time I was speeding down this highway and I slept in a backseat, dreaming in the Aramid. We turn up the country radio. I said, if you want me, just say so. And I slicked back my hair in the wind. And I told you I didn't want my picture taken. Yeah. You snapped it anyway. Now I guess. I guess you won't have trouble remembering me someday, someday, yeah. So I flirted, smoothed around the reins, and I kept wishing it was you instead of me behind the wheel. So maybe with my camera I could steal a shot of you and go home to put it in my room. And I told you I didn't my picture taken. You snapped it anyway. Now I guess now, I guess you won't have trouble remembering me someday, someday. Maybe you'll never remember me. Maybe my face will lose these scars. Sometimes they keep me up at night when I talk under the covers and rules and I see the light. Whoa. Whoa.
Oh. so good. Angie, you also, yeah, you sound fantastic.
What?
You sound fantastic. Oh. This is so great.
Andrew something, 2012 or
2015?
2012.
Good morning, Josh. You know what I'm saying.
So we got to perform here last night, where Under Oath has played before, where the Huntingtons have played before, Calibretto 13 has played before, our boy Kevin Schlereth representing, good old Disciple.
So
we have how much to burn?
We have about 5 to 6 truckloads of wood, big wood.
All that mess.
And then we have all the brush and then the crates. All those need to be burned.
Sick.
Can I just use this
that's
stick
disgusting.
Right here?
Yeah,
that's Goliath, and then you got Moses right there.
Dude, I love that pit for cooking.
Yeah, this is right. Thanks, guys.
Yeah, yep. No problem.
Jesse, he was gonna be the cook grill guy, but he Cassie had to leave and she's coming back, and now he's got to take care of Oakley and feed him right
yeah,
now.
Yeah, no problem. Yeah. Don't worry about it.
This is what you just said, though. Thank you for coming to my house and eating my food.
Fire!
You were a pit on fire!
You were a pit on fire.
Mixtape is hot. It's gonna be fire.
Hey, yo, I
those
killed each
delicious.
One of these chickens with my bare hands, and the cows too. I'm just saying. I punched it right in the snout.
Cows are people.
Cows have 46 chromosomes. You have 46 chromosomes.
Juggalo.
Jesus doesn't lose cows.
If you caught me up all night, it'd still be worth the lack of rest you could use. My trouble head, you'd have a cigarette or two. In your van, we'd sing the blues. And every song we sang about love, I was singing it to you, and I wish you knew. Oh, I should have told you. But now years past, it didn't last. I don't see you anymore, but I still sing about you. You were the best part of that year I had to lose. And I miss you. I miss you. And I miss you, and I miss you. But now I sit here by myself and I sing the blues. Yeah.
Oh, hey, what's up, MTV? Come on in. This is my crib out here in the Nasty Nash. Let me show you around. See, this house used to belong to, this is the basement, not that. It's a P. Diddy. If you follow me down here, I'll show you some real cool stuff. This is where he made all the hits, you know. I can't name any, but this is where it happened. This is where all the magic happens for my mixtapes. Just, you know, this is where Spitfire in there. And, they are dancing. Anyway, you can come on in here. This is the live room. All top of the line, state of the art. That's my Martin, recently endorsed by them. And I think that's it. Let's cut there. I can't think of anything. I'm really tired.
Soundtrack for the trip.
30 minutes of this. Go.
Neon sandals on my toes. Neon sandals on my toes.
Now he takes off her dress. Now let me go.
You're on thing. You see it happy, so you still hope.
Starting the day off right with Riff Raff.
Dion sandals on my toe.
Dion sandals on my toe.
Lose Yourself is my favorite song. Even Ask Mike.
Jurassic Park, bro.
It's probably the best song that I've ever
Let's watch Jurassic Park.
I said it's Dan Vale, Washington, the best actor ever. He's so darn cool. He's so darn clever. I think that you're the man. And Mike does too. Denzel, if you want.
Like an introduction of like where my issues with identity has kind of started. So it's called porn. I'm that creative. Alright. I used to be daddy's little girl. I used to be the sweetest little girl with freckles and red curls, and I knew nothing of this world. All I knew was the beauty that was in my daddy's eye, and I was the apple of my daddy's eye. It wasn't until I was 16 when I came across a computer screen with Lady Lust whispering these things. She told me what the boys want, said, I got what you don't got, and I forgot. She taught me what's hot and what's not, and before I knew what to think, I started to think. Now she's always calling me, never stops calling. She turns heads even when she's crawling, and I'm always trying to crawl behind her, dragging myself through the dirt to prove I'm just as good as her. But she always gets the attention, and I'm always left with my own reflection, shaking its head in disapproval at what each other sees. Her long and lusty legs are tied around my lonely fleshly mind, making me completely blind to who I am inside. He says that he loves me, tells me that he loves me, then falls asleep next to her. And what else am I supposed to do when it hurts other than take off everything but a t-shirt? Do a dance, take a picture, learn to flirt? God knows I can't compete with her! God, I hate her! Part of me just wants the beer because you take her so damn seriously. You're so dedicated, you never let her down, and I'm so asphyxiated. Are you gonna let me drown in lies about myself? I'm dying for you to know me for more than just my body. Why can't we just get coffee? And you can see me just for me. You tell me that you do. You say that you do, but I know that when you're alone in your room, she's the one that you'll be dreaming about tonight. So I'll do whatever it takes. I'll do more than just handshakes. I'll do whatever. Just want you to see me. Please just know my name. And while you're screaming, I'm here screaming, and the pastor's preaching. And I'm torn between what you seem to want and being me. So I've lost myself in my own thoughts. I've lost myself in snapshots. I've lost my self-esteem. I've lost myself in competition with the screen. This is the repercussions of pornography. Boom.
If magic is all we've ever known, then it's easy to miss what really goes on. But I've seen miracles in every way, and I see miracles every day. Oceans spanning beyond my sight, and a million stars way above them at night. You don't have to be high to look in the sky and know that's a miracle open wide. Look at the mountains, trees, the seven seas, and everything chilling underwater. Please, hot lava, snow, rain, and fog.
I gotta take this ball.